We're excited about being here on this Sunday in the new year, January the 9th. Our theme for this month, I think I'm going to leave it maybe through the month, but our theme has become renewed in 22. You can shake everybody's hand, but glad to see you this morning. Appreciate you being here. Thank the Lord for you being here. Thank you that are streaming with us. We're so proud to have you with us. Welcome to church. I want to pray God's protection over all here in COVID-19 and COVID variants and whatever they call them. Amen. Remember to pray for all the prayer line requests. Let's pray for Charles and Lois Clark. Pray for God protects them. Pray for Debbie Brooks and her family. And also, I got a rope down here, Debbie's son, his neighbor's home. I'm not sure if it's a mobile home or what, but burning down. And the heat, whatever, destroyed his home, her son's home. So we're praying for them. We're praying for Francis and Don Staples. Good to see them here today. Praying for Peggy Bridges and her family. Good to have them here. Praying for Brother Ralph and Sister Shirley. Touch them. Praying for Roy and Kat and Sister Annie. They all be here this morning. We appreciate them being here. Pray for Kay and Kay Lisa and Mike Gilly, Colin Woody, Dee Dee Woody, and Annie Hamright. Susan and Mary Robinson have been sick. They have several family members with COVID. David Brooks' son, I just told you about. Pray for Dee Dee Woody. She's been in the hospital all week. Very sick, kind of been up and down. The last we heard from Debbie last night, she had dialysis and she was doing pretty good. And I believe she's going to be all right, so just keep praying for her and Debbie. And Debbie has several family members that also have COVID, her grandkids' kids. Stevie had it. I think he's through with it now, but just pray for her family. Pray for, as I said, Dee Dee Woody in the hospital. Pray for Tracy. She was in the hospital as of yesterday. If she didn't get to come home, she's in the hospital, and they've checked her 3 times, and as of yesterday, said she didn't have COVID. She tested negative, but she's got some kind of respiratory problem. She's in the hospital. But all of her 2 daughters and Nina had it, and they're clear, I think, but they're still home and recovering, so pray for them. There's a lot of folks sick today, and we pray for all of them. Taking any of it lightly. Pray for my sisters. Pray for Geraldine. She's better. Louise is home from the hospital. Still needs a touch, as far as I know. And she is home. And Sister Betty, it's good to have her and Carolyn. We're praying for them. And she still has needs in her life concerning the loss of her husband. So let's keep her before the Lord. And then Marcella, she's pray for all them, their families. Pray for Wendell, he's doing much better. Still has a special need. Pray for Tyler Weaver. She continues cancer treatments. I kind of got lost over this week or last week, but I do be praying for her. Pray for Marcia as she recovers from a serious automobile accident. Glad that a lot of people are getting better, like Brother John. Thank God for that. Pray for all the unspoken requests. We know God will deliver all these people. Pray for Kalinowski's family and all the bereaved families. David Mitchell, Betty's Owensby Collins' niece that she lives with, for you that don't know her. Her husband's been in the hospital, and I think he's clear of COVID. He's got some other kind of pancreatitis, something like what it says. I know that's pretty tough. Brother Wilson does too. We've had that pancreatitis. And so we're just praying for him. Praying for all these. Unspoken requests, that I'll see in hand. If I miss somebody, some of them are sick this week. I'm praying for her. But she's been without heat since Christmas, before Christmas, I think, maybe the 21st of, something like the 21st of December. And she had to get rough with them, and they got rough with her, but they put a unit in yesterday. I don't know what they're going to do. They may make her move because she just refused to pay any more rent. They got some heat, you know. And she's been sick. It's been 60-some degrees in her house. So we pray for her. We can all touch her. Anybody else up here that need to pray one Bible here? Anybody else working for her today? Sister Marcia.
I don't know. Thank the Lord. I feel a lot better. Still got a headache I can't get rid of, but I'm feeling better. And God's really working things out. I know He is, and I'm trusting Him. Yesterday, I went out to Big Lot, and there was a homeless man out there. His name was Frank. And when I come out, he said, "Ma'am, can you help me get me something to eat?" So So I walked over there and talked to him for a little bit and asked if he knew the Lord, you know. I thought about Jimmy, you know, how Jimmy always said, you know, tell him about Jesus. And he'd say, if you give money, don't worry about it. You've done what's right. Don't worry about what to do with it. But he told me, he said, I have stage 4 cancer. And he said, I can't get any help. He said, I'm trying to get his disability started. And he said, they told him he'd probably be dead before his birthday next month. I mean, just really, and I watched his eyes and I watched him when he was talking. So I believe he was sincere. And so he just, his name is Frank. And I just told him, I said, you hold on to Jesus and whatever happens, I said, if he takes you, you'll be in a better place. You won't be hurt. And he said he hurts all the time. The pain never goes away. And so just remember Frank.
Okay. Anybody else here in the middle?
Just thank the Lord for making provisions and hold up all the TV requests. Several of them ask, make sure Pastor Chambers gets these. I said, he will.
We got them. We're praying over them. We're begging them. We prayed over them last night. I did have a lot. I had a lot of new callers. And, I believe it's working. I believe God's working. I thank God for streaming. I think it works. It's like Facebook and TV and anything else in the social media realm. There's a lot of junk on it.
Amen.
A lot of things that's not good. But if somebody hears the word, we had a man from across the country call one morning and said, got saved. Had a woman in the UK called and said she was on her way to the hospital. That's when we first started listening, maybe a year ago. And she called back before the program was over, before the service was over, and she said, I'm on my way home. Everything's fine. Thank you for praying, you know. So, I mean, it reaches out to people. I mean, you know, it may make lazy Christians. I hope it don't, you know. I mean, because it'd be easier to stay home, but I think it's a good thing. I'm so glad to have you today. And if you're able to go to church, think about getting back to church, because that's what you need to do. But if you're not, we're glad you listen to it either way. Amen. Did I miss anybody? Over here? Anybody? I'm sorry.
Remember my family. Remember God and Houston,
pretty sick this week. Donnie's sick and her family. Sister Francis. Anybody else over here? Still praying for Peggy's family. Her friend. Anybody else? Over here, still praying for Harvey's grandbaby. I understand he's doing good.
Yes, he's doing good. We saw him on Thursday.
Praise the Lord. Amen. You see, Sister Lois come in. We just request a prayer for you and all the love. Amen. Anybody else? All right. Richard is still having trouble with sight. Young preacher, Charlie's age, graduated with her, pastor of Revolution Church on Franklin. And he's just about lost his sight. Got one place where he couldn't see. And he's in the pulpit this morning, so we thank the Lord for that.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise
Anybody
God.
Up? Praise Amen. God. That's right. Anybody else?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
This opportunity to gather in your house this morning, Lord God. Pray for all these requests that's been brought up this morning, Lord. I trust you and believe in you to stand and cast healing in each and every one of them. Thank you. on the TV.
Father, we just thank you, Lord God, for making provisions for us, Lord God, for making a way, Lord. Father, we just ask you now to bless this offering, Lord, as we bring it to the altar, Lord God, and we'll just praise you and give you the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
Well, I'm going home. I'm going home. There is happiness. And we'd be so glad when that's all done. And somebody paid for it. Amen.
Glory to God. Amen. Amen.
Somebody, I don't know who, right? I might have an idea, but I don't know who. And, you know, I believe the old scripture, you know, that says if you do it in secret, God will reward you openly. We do thank God for it. And if you feel led to help on the other, we appreciate anything you do. Amen. The scripture this morning, Daniel chapter 6, verse 10. Now, when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went into his house, and his windows being open in his chamber toward Jerusalem, he kneeled upon his knees 3 times a day and prayed and gave thanks before his God as he did aforetime. That's the most powerful line in this, as he did aforetime. Nothing has changed. Somebody look at somebody and say, I'm on my way to heaven. I'm going home, and nothing's changed. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm just as excited today as I was yesterday. I've let the devil sap my joy 2 or 3 times. But I'm telling you, I'm going to try my best. I mean, you know, everything's not well. I got a lot of work going on at my house. And, you know, got to do this tomorrow and this the next day and this the next day. But it don't matter. I'm here right now. I may not live till tomorrow. I'm going to enjoy the blessings of the Lord today. I'm going to praise God today for what he's got. You know, Betty's been having trouble for ever since she had that surgery with her stomach, and that's flared up again. But the devil's a liar.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
We're praying for her in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Charlie, Kim wants you to lay hands on her right there. She don't have to come. Father, right now, in Jesus' name, I ask that you heal Betty this stomach condition that she's had for over a year, Lord. This flares up every month or so, Lord. If that's what it is, or if it's something else, we call it healed and whole in Jesus' name. Amen. And the church said, amen. Bless this message today in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. We're going to read the back of the newsletter, but I may do like I did last year and just read it and talk about it a little bit. Amen. We love you. And I'm praying for you to get better today. Told her she could stay home today. She said, I'll wear my mask, but I'm going, you know.
Amen.
Don't have no fever, so that's what we're doing. You know, just do what you feel like you've got to do. Trust God. The Bible says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. That don't mean believe what you want to believe. That means if you want to wear a mask, wear one. Amen.
Amen.
If you don't want to wear one, don't wear one. I'm going to trust God. Because I go into places nobody has along with me, and I go into places I don't have one, everybody else has one. I just believe God's going to take care of us. Amen. And I'm trusting him.
Man.
And I believe he's going to see us through. And again, thank you for screaming today. Amen. Hallelujah anyhow. What that just means there in that, you know, that you praise God anyway, you know. And that's what I've come to, you know. I was going to do some things financially and found out that there was more money than I could afford, so I had to put it on hold. And, you know, when you want to do something like that, you get a little down sometimes and say, well, maybe, you know, I shouldn't have wanted to do that, or maybe I want to do it. You can kick a can if you want to and get mad. But that thing's not going to bother me no more if I do it, because the Word says all things work together for good to them that love God, who are the called according to his purpose. If somebody says something that offends me, it may knock me down for a little bit, but I'm going to get up. Amen.
That's right.
I ain't going to stay down. If you want to stay down, you stay down. But I made up my mind. I made up my mind that I'm going on with Jesus. Amen. Having back therapy, and it's kind of up and down. One day it kills me, the next day it helps me. Amen. So I can't hardly tell what's going on there, but I'm telling you, I'm walking this morning.
Amen. Yes.
Don't
amen.
Don't have a cane. Amen. Don't have nothing to help me. And my feet hurt a little bit. My back hurts a little bit, but I'm here. And I don't have nothing to be down about. Everything's good in the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
This world's not good. This world has decided to go way away from God. And if they don't come back, God help them and help us until he comes and gets us. Somebody say
amen.
But for today, me and my house going to serve the Lord.
Amen.
And Habakkuk said, if there's no herds in the field and no herds in the stock, in the stalls, in the barn, I am going to rejoice in the God of my salvation.
Amen.
And that's what I'm going to do today. Yes. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And this message is just simply saying, if you ever was close to God, if you ever had a walk with God, if you ever had it worked out where you was reading your Bible every day, where you had your devotions every morning, and that kind of thing, and the devil's tried to push that away. I said lately, and I preached the other night, that we need to lay aside the sins and the weights that so easily beset us.
Yes.
Somebody might have got a little confused about what I said on TV last night, but that TV program was anointed last night. And when I watched it last night, I felt that same anointing I felt when I stood here and preached Wednesday. So I know God's in this, and I know God's a healer. But I said the other day, I wasn't conceding to defeat, but I had an accident that affects my memory. 6 years ago, but it still affects my memory some. And I can tell you that I do. Am I going to give in to that? No. Am I going to quit preaching? If I lose my thought, am I not going to say nothing else? No, I'm just going to go on with the thoughts I got and keep on preaching. But I gave this illustration on TV, if you didn't hear it. Let me just bear with me a minute and let me do it one more time. I said, you know, as you get older, you know, I'm not that old, but I'm 70. I'm the years God promised. And as you get older, they say your mind gets weaker.
That's
I'm guessing it does. You know, my arms are weaker, my legs are weaker, my back's weaker, my stomach don't work like it did 30 years ago, you know. So it stands to reason that don't have to happen. God, I know people. Sister Nancy, she died at about 90, and she was, her mind was just as new and fresh as it was when I met her in her 60s or 70s.
Amen. Amen.
So God's God. God still takes care of us. She was late 80s or early 90s when she left here. And me and Betty talked about it. Her body was gone, her strength was gone, but her mind was just as fresh. And so that can happen. But if it gets a little weak, don't give in to it. Just do things to keep you focused and keep focused on God. But my whole point in that is that sometimes when I got a thought, it may be some simple thing, and somebody shut that door over there, and my thought would go away. But you know what I do? I look away from that door and try to get my mind back on what I'm doing, and in a minute it comes back around.
Amen.
Well, that's the same thing spiritually. When the devil tries to afflict you or get you down, or your friends come against you, as they did here in Daniel, you know, when you regroup, when you just have to, you know, the weights that easily beset us, they easily put us aside, they easily knock us down. Amen. But we got to get back up. We got to keep going. And I'm not sure that Daniel, it doesn't say that he had anything negative going on here. But the Bible does say that he knew the writing that was signed. So he was aware of it. Amen.
Amen.
And he had the choice. Well, if I pray, they're going to come get me. Amen. If I don't pray, they're going to be mad at me and come get me anyway. So I'm going to pray anyway. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. That's
Amen.
What we have to do. You know, we have to do that. Mordecai told Esther, said, if you don't go in and see the king, you know, we're going to die anyway, you know? And so that's what made her have the thinking. I got it in my notes, so I'll say it again. That's what made her say, if I perish, I perish. Because Mordecai told her, said, just being in the kingdom, just being in the church, just being in God's presence is not going to spare your life if judgment falls on this place. Amen.
Amen.
And so what's going to happen is we're going to go on and be with the Lord. It's just going to be a little temporary pain. It's going to be a little temporary infection. And then we're going home to be with Jesus.
Amen.
Somebody say
amen. Glory to God.
I believe that.
Amen.
Daniel said, when he knew the writing was written, did he do any more than he normally did? No. I mean, some people will try to say, well, I'm going to do more than I ever had. I'm going to show the devil. Why don't you just keep on doing what you're doing? What you're doing works. If what you're doing keeps you walking with God and keeps you talking with God,
Amen.
There's nothing wrong with increasing. John said, I must decrease, and he must increase, and I must decrease. So there's nothing wrong with that. Somebody say there's nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with you growing in the Lord. We all do. The Bible says grow in the Lord.
Amen.
And be strong in the Lord, in the power of his might. That's what we're to do. That's what the Word of God tells us to do. And we're supposed to do that. And I hope you're enduring or striving, to do that. That you just do more. But if you fail, just try to get back where you were at. I used to say a lot of times, I want to go with God places I've never gone before. And I have not lost that vision. I still do. But what I'd like to do first is get back where I once was with God. Get back to the level of the power and anointing. I mean, I prayed for people to get healed. Sister Annie talked the other week about how her foot got healed when it was just a simple prayer. And to be honest with you, I remember it, but I don't remember making a big to-do of it. I just prayed for her foot, and it got better. And I've seen a lot of people like that. That don't happen every time I pray. But I got to believe every time I pray, it can happen. Somebody hear me.
Amen.
I
got to
believe every time I pray, you can get better.
Amen.
You can be healed in Jesus' name. Do I believe in divine healing with all my heart?
Yes.
I believe God will do it.
Yes.
But he didn't do no less. He didn't do no more. He went into his house, and his windows being open. I mean, you think about it. Would he have been sinning if he had pulled the shade down? I don't think so. But he was telling them, I'm not ashamed of what I did for Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Not ashamed of what I believe. If it goes against your grain, I'm sorry. If you can show me in the Word of God where I'm wrong, I'll repent and change my mind. But if it's the Word of God, I preach Wednesday night about being faithful to doctrine. Amen. Being faithful to the Word of God. If you can back it up with the Word of God, anything God tells you in the Spirit, I believe it. If there's a scripture that can back it up. Because he said the Word and the Spirit agree. They are not contrary one to the other. Amen. When he knew the writing was signed, he went into his house. His windows being open in his chamber toward Jerusalem. I mean, you know, he just said, well, that's too bright over. He could have used another excuse. He said, well, the sun's too bright over. I'm going to open this up. And went, no. He wanted the devil to know had nothing changed. Amen.
Amen.
He wanted the devil to know that everything was just the same. I'm on my way to heaven. It feels good. I'm on my way to heaven and the journey gets sweeter every day. Does it get sweeter every day? Actually, preacher, do you do? Does it better today than it was yesterday? Most days, but some days it's not. I have to hope tomorrow to what's coming in the morning. If I can make it to another day, I'll get it back what I had yesterday. Amen.
Amen.
And don't moan and groan and complain. I hear people say things like, I hear people this week, several people told me, I can't complain. And a couple others told me, said, won't do no good, nobody won't listen. Pity party, don't nobody show up, you heard all that. I've said some of that. But I'll tell you what really happens when you complain, your spirit comes down a notch. When you get in a fault-finding mood, your spirit comes down a notch. When you get the word you weep in the faith, you know your spirit comes down. So what you got to do is the faith level drops. I mean, I don't keep my car full all the time, but everybody's got a certain mark. I mean, I used to, and I guess that's part of getting old, but Murphy, Betty's stepdad, most of you know him, but those that don't, he went to be with the Lord in 01, been gone 20 years, but he had a truck, and he was proud of that truck. And every time if it got down to half a tank, he'd just feel like he'd be walking with the Lord. I gotta get some gas. And I rode around mine all the time on empty, and Jimmy rode around his all the time on empty. And Jimmy said when his truck went, it wasn't gonna get him for no gas, so he put $5 at a time in it. That kind of thing. Everybody's got their own thing, amen.
Yeah.
But as I've got older, I don't like to let my head under half a tank now, you know.
Yeah.
But it's still a level, but I don't stop and fill it up by usually a gallon or 2 gallon. And sometimes I can tell, I know where it's at. You know, Betty will say, I'm going to take your truck. I said, go ahead, got plenty of gas. Go ahead, got plenty of gas. I want you to come and pray for me, preacher. I got plenty of spiritual gas right now.
Amen.
I'm not running on empty this morning. Somebody say amen.
Come on.
I'm not as full as I'd like to be, but I'm not on empty. Somebody
say amen. Amen.
So that's the way he was. He signed it. It was signed. He didn't sign it. He knew it was signed. He went into his house, the window being open. Everything it says here, toward being open his chamber toward Jerusalem, I think that's the way it was every time he prayed.
Yeah.
And it was one more sign. He was telling the people, if you're looking at me, had nothing changed. Amen. He kneeled upon his knees. Sometimes people say pray. We say a little quick prayer, turn over in our bed, pray a prayer, get back up. But his custom was to get on his knee. So he got on his knee. And he wasn't doing it as a show, but he did it when they wasn't looking.
Amen.
So don't change when somebody's looking. Don't change when you get around somebody don't believe what you believe. So I'm sorry to offend you, but I believe in this rapture or whatever you're standing for. I believe in this.
Amen.
So if you offend it, I'm sorry, but I'm not going to quit saying it. You know, I'm going to keep on believing it and keep on claiming that Jesus is coming back. Our Lord is coming back to earth again. He kneeled upon his knee 3 times a day. I don't think that was the only time he prayed. He probably had a prayerful spirit, prayed when he wanted to, but he had a set time.
Amen.
Whether it was, you know, in the 9 o'clock hour, the 12 o'clock hour, 6 o'clock, first, second, third, fourth, watch of the day or the night. I don't know what it was, but he had regular time. And he got time to pray, and he knew what was written. He went in there, the window was up, he didn't raise it, but he didn't shut it.
Amen.
You know
what I mean? Amen.
You don't have to toot your horn all the time, tell people what you do all the time. God knows. But if you're doing something that you know is going to offend somebody, you know it's the will of God, I don't think you have to be flamboyant about it or go around and talk rough to them and say, I'm going to do this, I don't care what happens to you, what happens. You don't have to do all that. Just keep doing what you're doing. Just keep being faithful to God because he's the one we do it for anyway. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And he prayed. And he prayed. And then the next sign said, and he gave thanks before his God. I think if I'd got to pray in a situation like that, I think one of my first thoughts would have been, God, you know what they're going to do to me for this. God, you know they're coming after me. God, you know they're fixing to get me for this. You know, they're going to get me. They're going to stop us from streaming. They're going to shut the church down. Two families are going to leave, you know. That's what I tell God first if I have a problem most of the time. Not all the time, but most of the time. I'm talking about it in the natural. That's the way we pray. Somebody say amen.
Amen. That's right.
But you don't have to pray like that. Daniel prayed and gave thanks before his God. And then that powerful four words there, as he did a full time. In the newsletter I wrote, sometimes we're required by God to know what we're facing. I mean, I just should not know. I mean, I don't know what tomorrow holds, but I know who holds tomorrow, and that's good enough for me.
Right.
I got bad news coming in the morning. Don't tell me early. Amen. Just let me get it when he gets here. Amen.
Amen.
Let me hear it when he gets here. Sometimes, but God requires us to know. The Bible said when Abraham offered up Isaac, said that he went to a place not knowing where it was, but when he got to inside of it, the Bible said he saw that place. Sometimes we see the place we go on, we don't like it, but we got to walk on. When I can't see what's in front of me, I walk on and just believe. Amen.
Amen.
That's what we have to do. I stand for Jesus and let the world go by. I'm getting ahead of myself. In knowing what trouble lies ahead, we're faced with a choice, and there's just two of them, continue or retreat. He could pull the shade down. He could pray in private. He could just not pray, or just went on forward doing what he always done. And I think that's what we got to do. The devil would love to know what you would do in a like circumstance. If he could tell you tomorrow, you know, somebody's kid passes away, and my heart goes out. I've never had that happen to me, but I'm grieved with those people. We saw a TV program, an old Western, the other night, done in the 50s, and it was a good program, but at the end, they come and told this woman her boy got killed. And I told Betty, I said, that's depressing. I said, that is depressing. I said, I know it's a movie, and I know it's real life. But I mean, I like to hear it to pray, but I don't like to hear makeup stories, you know, on TV before they done it. And, you know, it was over, and it was the end of it, and I was just sitting on the couch getting ready for bed, so I didn't turn it off. But that's not, and I commented to her, I said, that's depressing, because I deal with it in real life. I've been to people's houses at 1 o'clock in the morning in the 42 years I've been here and told a 13 to 14-year-old boy their daddy wasn't coming home. He got killed in a car wreck, a truck wreck. I mean, I've had to do that. I had to go. I went and looked. I woke Jess and Margie up one time before daylight, Betty's uncle and aunt, and told them another one of the children that got killed, you know? And so that's sad, and that hurts. And I may be going to lose one tomorrow. I pray I don't. But if I do, God will give me the strength to go through. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
All my hope is in Jesus.
Amen.
Somebody tell somebody, all my hope is in Jesus. Amen. I'm not looking to the president. If Trump gets back in, I'm not looking to him. If Biden stays in, or worse, if he could be any worse than what we got, and it could be, and if somebody else comes in, my hope's not in them. My hope is in the blood of Jesus Christ that he shed for me, that he said he wouldn't let me go unprotected. He would not allow me. He would not permit. He would not okay me to be tempted above what I think was best.
Amen.
Yes, we got to stick with that. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Against all opposition, Daniel would. All against all opposition. This sounds like a statement, but it's a question. Sometimes, against all opposition, like Daniel, would we do as he always had aforetime and pray anyway? And I could have said anyhow. Amen. Mm-hmm. One more time there. Would we do that? In discouraging times like this, we are commanded by God to stay faithful.
Amen.
Our message title represents Daniel and all those who have decided when trouble comes to say hallelujah anyhow.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to praise you anyway. The true saints of God are in a minority group who have decided to stand for Jesus and let the world go by.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you for those amens. I believe it, and I'm glad you believe it.
Amen.
Since we know the devil is out to get us, and we know that God's mandate is for us has not changed, we must stay focused on God.
Amen.
I said, we must stay focused on God. Listen to this. I'm in the last paragraph, if it's on the board or if it's on the newsletter. Amen. If there's any quit in us, we better rest assured the devil's going to find it.
That's right.
Job said, the thing I have feared worst has come upon me. So I don't believe the devil can read your mind, so I think at some time in Job's life he must have said, if so much happened to him, I don't know which one he was talking about. Maybe that was what it was. If I ever get down to nothing and lose everything, that's my fear. Or losing my kids. Or my wife turning against me. My wife not agreeing with me. Whatever it was, I believe at some time or another he either said it or somebody else said it, and he had a sad face, and the devil's watching. Devil has to just, I believe that he did that. I believe he went to God because he had heard Job say or think, hear somebody else say, that if that ever happened to me, I'd quit. And I'm telling you, the devil love to know what it would take to get you to quit. If there's any quit in it, rest assured the devil will find it. When we make up our mind to go through, we must have the mind of Queen Esther. Esther said in difficult times, when it didn't look like there's no way for her to do what she was doing, she said, if I perish, I perish, or hallelujah anyhow, and we must never quit. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
In one short verse, there's a two-part message here in this verse, and I'll be through quickly. Number one, Daniel was fully aware of the time or the situation he was in. I mean, you know, I'd like to say business as usual, but we have on a good time 25 or 30 people here, and sometimes 10 or 15. And before COVID hit 2 years ago, it wasn't unusual to have 50 or 60 here, you know? But we haven't got back up to half strength that we was before. So nothing being wrong with you being aware of the situation, what's going on in your life. There's churches that's still running 100 or 200, it used to run 300, 400, 500 before.
That's right.
So if COVID did what the devil wanted to do, it divided the government, it divided families, it divided the church. Amen. Somebody hear you.
Right.
Amen. But knowing that exists don't mean that we have to give in to it. He was fully aware of the time or the situation he was in. And if you know, the doctor said, like the man, I mean, I was here with Jack Hovis when he came. And I don't think he'd mind me telling it. I'd never seen nobody with the faith he had. He come in one Friday night, and I knew Thursday or Friday he was going to hear from results from some tests they took. And we got through praying. He wasn't here at 7 o'clock, but the two or three of us here, we prayed. I don't remember who, Betty and me, it seemed like one or two more. But we were here praying on Friday night, and I just sat back on the altar waiting for whoever was praying last to quit. We wouldn't get up legally, it was all through praying. Jack walked in that door back there, and he was just smiling and looking around. And I said, you ever hear anything from those tests, brother? He said, yep, doctor told me I got stage 4 cancer. I mean, I never heard nobody answer me and say that like he said it.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about this morning. Amen.
Yes.
He sat down on the altar and started telling me where he wanted his service,
yeah,
what he wanted to do, what he wanted me to say, which funeral home he wanted. And even in his dying, he was trying to be convenient for everybody else, not interrupt nobody. I mean, what faith he had. And that's what we got to do. I mean, that's what we got to do. I'm not saying that nobody couldn't pray him out of that sickness, but sometimes there is a sickness unto death. Jesus said about Lazarus when he went to raise him up, this sickness is not unto death. And the devil will steal you early if he can. If Jack come in, he told me what he's going to do, so I want you to preach my funeral. I want to be here. He said, I want to be at this funeral home out here on Whiteside Road. I want my funeral to be here, and I want to go back on Best Receiver and be buried and not hold everybody up all day. He said, I want it to be done right. And my mouth fell open, I'm sure. I just sat there and said, what faith? I don't know if I'd be talking like you taught me, brother, if the doctor talked like I had 30 or 40 days to live. And that's what he talked like to him. And I think he lived 2 or 3 months total. But he never changed. Never changed. I never seen such faith in all my life. From just an individual, not a preacher. He was a Sunday school superintendent. He did devotions. He done a good job. He was a good man. He helped me as much as any earthly man's ever helped me. But he wasn't God. And I hate to lose him. I hate him to go on, for him to go on. But sometimes we just have to stand back and say, let go and let God have his wonderful way.
Yes.
Let go and let God have his way. He was 72. He lived out his years. His mother just died at 95. And I told him that. I had tried to have faith. I said, brother, your mama lived to be 95. And I said, you don't have to give in to this. And I said, look at Brother Wilson. He's almost 90. He said, yeah, but he's tough as nails. He's tough as nails. And he didn't say nothing wasn't wrong. Brother Wilson is tough as nails. He's still 91 years old. Amen. But he didn't give in to it. That's the way I want to be. That's the way I want to be. If the devil would say it, or if the God would say it, or the doctors would tell me, it's your last day on earth. I hope I'd go out. I want to go out praising the Lord.
Yeah.
One song says, when I die, funeral plans, let me die praising the Lord. I think a Pentecostal person wrote that song and originally said, let me go speaking in tongues. Uh-huh. And so I'm not ashamed of that neither. That'd be all right. I've heard people that went out speaking in tongues.
Yeah.
But praising his name, speaking in tongues, whatever works for you, I just like to go out doing all of it. Amen. I'd like to go out doing all of it. And if I ever die in the pulpit, don't you ever say the devil attacked me. I mean, being with my family and being with the church and being with the church family and preaching the gospel is what my life is about. It's in a circle here.
Yeah.
My family and, God first and my wife and my children, my grandchildren and all my family that going out there. And I got a big family. If you get all the way out there, you'll be in Charlotte before you know it. Big school. Amen. All my family. And doing the will of God and preaching this gospel. I mean, I've had my life where it went that way and that way and that way and that way. Not no more. Not no more. I mean, I got a circle here and I'm trying to stay in it. I feel like God's put me in a circle and I better stay in it.
Amen.
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 Yes. Amen.
Praise the
yes.
Lord.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
Amen. He's aware of the situation.
Yes, Lord.
Number two, and you can come, brother, I'm closing. He had a working plan with his God, and he stuck with it. That's what I want to do. If I just lie this now, then I'll stand before God for lying. But if God's got me in that circle, I better stay in it.
Amen, that's right.
Somebody hear me.
Yes.
My arm will have to go all the way around. Just all the way around. I turn around, I fall. So you know what I'm doing? I got a circle that I got to stay in. I can't go out of that. Amen. No matter who asks me, I feel like Nehemiah when he was on that wall and said, just come down and talk to us. We just want to talk. And the Bible said he thought to do it mischief. And he said, I can't come down. I can't come down. I'm sorry you think I'm messing up. I'm sorry you think that I don't have the right theology and the right doctrine and I've misinterpreted something in the Word of God. The Bible says it's no private interpretation. But it does say work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. And if I've ever had that worked out, I got that worked out now. I ain't got everything right in my life. Don't think I have. But I've got my salvation worked out with fear and trembling.
Amen.
And I start up here, I cross the line. I ain't going to do that. Start up here, I cross the line. I'm not going to do that for you, for nobody else. Amen. And not even for the devil. Not even for me. Amen. There's things I'd like to do myself, and I think that's a little bit on the line, James. You better stay off of that. You better stay off of that. Because if you get too close to the line, what will happen? You'll be over the line. Amen. I don't want to go over the line. One last thought. Come on, brother. One last thought. Just one line and I'm through. We must live our lives in service and devotion to God. If you believe, I'm going to read it again. But if you believe it, I want everybody to cover a sound and amen. Because I got one. We must live our lives in service and devotion to God, no matter the consequences.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. I love the Lord. Cindy, see, we had requests called in. If you haven't still got time to do it, text me. Monitor them and get them to us. If any more comes in, you get them to us. Stand your feet, dollars over, if you'd like to pray. Brother Tim, just go ahead. You don't have to wait. Just go ahead. And then if you're not able to get tired, then you sit down there and sing a verse or two, and then we'll give you these prayer requests. We'll pray over them, and we'll go home shortly. If you got a need, come to the altar this morning. Go ahead.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Robinson still dealing with that pain. Ryan Staten's been sick this week because of killing. Joyce Sanford asked for prayer for herself and her nephew. Ron Carpenter, we've been praying for Joyce. We believe in God to touch him. And son Chris Hollifield and mine, God touched him. Jennifer Counts asked for prayer again for herself and her mother. Terry White and Dawn watching again from Colorado. Terry's still dealing with kidney stones. We're praying for you in Jesus' name. Brother, you, Mr. Raven, watching from work, plans to be in church tonight. That's great. Sweet young girl started coming. Her name's Raven. And she texted in that she's watching from work. And she says tonight, amen. Susan, dear watching, ask for prayers. Would you help me pray for them? Stretch your hand for them. Father, I do. In Jesus' name. God, I love you. I thank you, Lord. I give you all the praise and all the glory. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Somebody not ashamed to say, in the name of Jesus. Say it again. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We love you and thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. More time, of course, whatever you like to do. You still come to the altar if you don't do well with your submission. Say, you are
Happy birthday.